everyone. In today's craft video, I'm going to show you how to make cereal box crowns. And here's what you'll need to make your own. So, of course, you're going to need a cereal box and some paint to decorate it with, as well as a paintbrush. And to decorate it, you can also use like stickers like these, or glitter, or you know, sequins, anything you like. And you'll also need some ribbon to tie it onto your head, and scissors to cut it out. Might need some glue as well. And then you'll also need a pencil to draw your design. And if you want, you can also use a template that I'll put the link in the description below for these templates that I used, because that just makes it a bit easier. And that's it. So let's get started. First thing you'll want to do, if you're using a template or you can make your own, you're going to draw out or trace your template onto the cardboard. So as you can see, I put it like this and just used my pencil here to draw, trace the template. And now I'm just going to finish cutting it out. Okay, so I finished cutting out this crown. Now I just need to paint it. And if the cereal box has lettering back here, I'd recommend painting it in white first, letting that dry, and then painting over it in whichever color you want. But since I don't have that, I'm just going to go ahead painting it. I'm going to do blue and pink. So, make sure you have like a paper towel or some newspaper under your mat or underneath, just so you don't get your table or whatever surface you're working on dirty. Okay, so next I'm going to paint the tops of the crown pink. I just need a bit of a smaller brush. So this crown is painted. Now I just have to wait for it to dry and then I can decorate it some more. So move this over here. And this crown is already dry and I already decorated it a little bit with some stick-on gems. I'm gonna stick a few more on just so it shows up better. I stuck on some more sparkly gems. Now the last step is you're going to need a hole punch. I forgot to mention this earlier, but you will need a hole punch and you're going to just poke a hole right at the ends of the crown. Then you're going to take your ribbon and loop it through. and then pull it tight across. It's nice and snug. And then you can tie it in the back. All right, so here's my purple crown. Okay, thanks guys for watching. I hope you have fun making your own crowns at home, and I'll see you next time. Bye.